everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you a few different ways to apply holes to your prints using Digital Factory OKI Edition. First, I'll go into applying holes based on transparency. When you open up the software, you will import your desired image by going to File, Import File. Select your desired file. For this example, we will use a rusty truck slash alien looking image. This file will load into the selected printer queue. From there, you'll want to make sure the print mode is on Forever Dark. Hit yes because we're sure we want to confirm the print mode change. Next, we will right click the file in the print queue and go down to production plugins and hit knock me black out. You want a transparent background because the color of the shirt will fill the black areas of the graphic, which will blend a lot nicer. For this example, the default settings should be fine. After you have your graphic with a transparent background, you can rip this file by right clicking the file and clicking on rip only, or use the keyboard shortcut Alt S. When the file is finished ripping, you can right-click the file and hit View Raw Data or keyboard shortcut Alt-V to see where the holes are being placed. Hit OK to confirm you want to view the raw data. You can zoom in to get a closer view. To get a better idea of where your whites will print, you can view all as black by clicking this button. All of the areas that appear solid black will print as solid or opaque colors. If you zoom in on the transparent areas, you can see the holes, which will give you that nice soft hand feel that everyone wants. By creating holes this way, the image will stay nice and vibrant while also blending very nicely. To show you the difference between the different methods of creating holes, we'll use the same image. Once it's imported, we'll change the print mode to Forever Dark Black Shirts. There will be a pop-up asking if you're sure you want to change the print mode. Hit yes. If you don't want a warning next time, you can hit remember this selection next time. If you double-click the image under the print queue, the job ticket properties menu will pop up and you can open the color layer list and open ink removal at the bottom. You can change the frequency and angle of the holes to your liking. For this example, we will use a frequency of 30 and an angle of 52.50. The next step is to use the Knock Me Black Out plugin like we did before. Right-click Production Plugins, Knock Me Black Out. A quick tip for this print mode, you'll want to lower the value for the underbase quite a bit to give us that white to black blend into the shirt. Usually between 30 to 40 is a good place to start. This will result in the preview window showing a more transparent image that isn't as vibrant. Hit OK. To counter the lack of vibrancy, you can double-click on the file and open up Color Layer and Processing Options. You'll be able to use a feature called Color Boost. This option affects only the transparent areas, and since our image is more transparent now, it will give us a nice boost and recover some of that lost vibrancy. For this example, we'll use a color boost of 6, keeping in mind that the more you boost, the more toner you will use. We are now ready to rip this file. Right-click Rip Only or keyboard shortcut Alt-S. We can view the raw data again by right-clicking and hitting View Raw Data or keyboard shortcut Alt-V. Confirm that you want to view the raw data. The big difference we're going to see here is holes throughout the image compared to just the transparent areas we saw previously. View all colors as black and you'll really notice that the holes vary in size with the gradient of the image. You can see the big difference is in the lettering. There are holes in the lettering since it's more transparent versus solid colors in the first example. For the third method of holes, we'll import our alien image again. A little tip, you can import your files by clicking on the icon with the green plus mark on it. Once the image is imported, we will change the print mode to Forever Dark with holes. Next, we'll double-click on the imported image and go to Color Layer and Ink Removal. To keep things consistent, we will use the same settings as we did with the previous example. That's a frequency of 30 and an angle of 52.50. We have a few different options here to play with. The hole size at 255 will leave the image with solid colors and no transparent areas. When we slide it left towards 0, the hole sizes will increase and will in turn increase the transparency of the image. The default is around 180. If you want to vary hole size in areas of partial transparency, the second slider will become enabled. This slider will affect only the areas in the image that are not solid. We will then use the Knock Me Black Out plugin. Hit OK. We're ready to rip and view the image again. Right-click Rip Only or keyboard shortcut Alt-S. View the raw data again by right-clicking and hitting View Raw Data or keyboard shortcut Alt-V. If we view everything as black again, you can see that all parts of the image will have holes in it and that the opaque areas will all have the same hole size. Since we checked varying hole size for transparent areas, it did just that. I'll show you another cool option, which is using stripes instead of holes. If we import our image once more and change the print mode to Forever Dark with stripes, and open up the job ticket properties and go to ink removal, we can see the shape is a line. Digital Factory OKI Edition offers 23 different shapes to choose from for your print. You can use the stripes or line option to try and match the weave of the fabric you're printing on. Comparing the three different hole types on the screen, you can see the vast differences in each. Different hole types will be used in different situations. For simple, solid color images, you'll probably use the Forever Dark with holes or the Forever Dark Black Shirts print modes. For more complex images with significant transparent elements, you'll probably want to use the Forever Dark print mode. There are a number of benefits to using holes in your prints. A better hand feel of the print on a shirt, extended life of the print and reduced fading, increased quality of your prints using the holes based on transparency. You'll also save toner without compromising print quality. And the presets make all of this a breeze. There you have it. Those are the three different hole types you can create with Digital Factory OKI Edition. For additional information about Digital Factory OKI Edition, you can visit cadlink.com. Thanks for watching. If this video helped you, hit the like button, and if you have any questions, please let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos covering all of Cadlink's products.